Hello guys, what is going on? Today I have yet another budget phone, the Doogee X95. This one has 2 gigs of RAM, 16 gigs of storage, the MediaTek 6737, 6.52 inch display, teardrop design, a 4350 mAh battery, and Android 10, all for around $50 or $60. So this phone seems to have great specs for the money. All right, and here we have the phone. Okay, this is the black version. I ordered a green phone. I don't know why they sent me black. Okay, so bottom bezel is there, but the top bezel is nearly non-existent. Overall, a nice design. In the box, we have our SIM ejector tool, some manuals, this warranty card, and our charging brick and charging cable. Pretty typical. Also, we get this little silicone case. So I guess all that's left to do is power it on. Alright, first impressions of the display. It looks nice and vibrant. Visibility is nice. Quality is nice. So I'm gonna set this up and get back to you. So here we go guys, the phone is all set up. I'm still downloading some stuff in the background because I had some connectivity problems. Not the phone's fault, I had some problems with the Wi-Fi. So this is the Android 10 Go edition, I guess. I don't know, I thought this was only with Android 8.1. Okay, so we have flashlight, basic service. Basic service, what is that? Okay, so it's like a device care like Samsung has. See about phone. Okay, so this is Android 10. Let's just tap that. Okay, yep. This is Android 10, alright. With the April security patch for some reason. Okay, we have no fingerprint sensor, but we do have face unlock. So we're gonna try that out. I gotta bring this up to my face for now. Okay, face unrolled. Let's see if it actually works. That was slow, but it worked. I'm gonna try it from close up. Okay, that was a bit faster with the face unlock. It's pretty slow and I bet it's gonna be very unreliable. So I would just go with no password at all and just leave it unlocked. I know that's what I did before fingerprint sensors were invented. So anyway, let's try our first game. Let's try Knife It. That's very laggy. Still a bit lagging. Let's try resetting the game because that helps sometimes. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty, okay, it's pretty slow. Okay, Wind Rider. Let's see. It's not running too bad. Looks like we're getting about 30-25 FPS, which yeah, it's a stuttering a bit. All right. Yeah, it's not bad actually. I mean, it's pretty hard because of the lag, but it is playable. I don't think anyone's gonna enjoy it like this though. No point in even trying PUBG because this phone is not meant for gaming at all. So yeah, to summarize, don't get this phone for gaming. Not even night gaming. Okay, I've heard enough. Okay, the speaker is quiet. It's getting very distorted. It's not a good speaker. I give it a 4 out of 10. Okay, pretty simple layout. Alright, before we take our first selfie, let's take a look at the settings real quick. So the front camera is 5 megapixels, and the rear camera is 13 megapixels, and we can record at only 720p on the rear camera, and on the front is 640 by 480. Now that we got the specs out of the way, let's take our first selfie. Let's turn off the light because this phone doesn't seem to like my external lighting system. No, wait, that's a video. Okay, guys, let's go outside. Okay, this is rear-facing video on the Doogee X95. Viewfinder, it looks stuttery. But if it doesn't, then I guess it's a pretty decent video, especially for 50 bucks. Oh god, it's Bumblebee. Alright, let's try and focus on this flower. Okay, out of focus doesn't work, but tapping the screen. Okay, can't focus even when tapping on the screen. Yeah, video is decent, I guess, if it's not stuttering. Okay, this is front-facing video on the Doogee X95, not even 720p. And on the phone, it looks pretty good, but I'm gonna guess that the video is gonna be unusable for social media, YouTube, because it's just, you know, 2008 potato quality video, but if you had to record a video, you could. If it was a life or death situation, there we go. All right, so that is pretty much it. Should you get this phone? My answer would be not for gaming at all or any tasks that it might struggle with. But for daily use, you know, reading a few apps, browsing, stuff like that, it's gonna do just fine. I mean, it's not the fastest phone in the world, but it is, I mean, for 50 bucks, it's perfectly acceptable. So don't go into comments like, oh, 50 bucks, what do you expect? People think just because it's a cheap phone that I can't say anything bad about it. But that's not true. You're still spending money on this. It should at least function properly, right? So yeah, as of like today, the phone functions just fine. But as for the future, nobody can be certain. But if it can run like this without lagging that much for a year at least, then that would be acceptable. So thank you so much for watching. More reviews coming in the future. I will see you in the next video. Peace.